Those innocent eyes. That smile on your face makes it easy to trust you. If they only knew the girl with the tattoo, like I do.
Look to the camera.
Pose.
Show me that silhouette that only your eyes know, that my clothes know. Embarrassed when I look over and see your skin glow. I'm a writer, so naturally you know how my pace goes. Content Spanish, subtitles and pesos, te quiero los manos, con mi papi when I say so. Wait. Hold on, let me run it back. I said, constant Spanish subtitles and pesos. Te quiero los manos con mi papi when I say so. I haven't done a language in a few years, but for a few minutes, nah, fuck that. For a few hours, Miguel will devour and stay here. But right now, pose. Show me that face that only my eyes know. Your iris meets my lens. Put this in the focus. Let me put my high definition in the motion. Games like Dragon Ball, wait for my power pole. I'll say it again, one more time. Miguel will devour for hours though. Behind the scenes, in this camera, you know it's me. You already know. My tongue game ain't just poking my poetry.
Someone once asked me what it means to be a freak. I told them it's the ones that like to keep it discreet. The ones that like to creep and sneak for the thrill of their capture. Because you want them easy whores, you look right past them. Most people know me by the name Janelle B, but they don't know my alter ego, Sweet Candy. See, Janelle is the lady and Candy is the freak, and together they will make the freakiest geek you ever meet. That other side of me is like a demon never seen. She be twisting up her tongue cause you know it's shine green. Tongue ring in her mouth if you know what she about. Never drought, second one soon cause you know she freaked out.
Woke up this morning, dick super stiff. Physically alone, but accompanied by my dreams, I reminisce. About body 22, see that's a bitch I miss. Dick sucks the best, softness to her lips. Sensuality in her kiss, breasts so supple. Ooh, the curves in her hips. I remember how that almost got me in trouble. Now I'm jerky. I remember how we got cool, started off just flirting. Follow her on Twitter, status said, hey, sleeping alone, so I started putting work in. Conversation took a tangent. I told her I love my 7 jeans, but I hate the color blue. I love orange soda, she turned into Kel. Asked me, is it true? Said she like her pink pussy, but the color blue most of all. I could tell she never played sports, cause nothing worse than a flat ball. Double that, cause I got two. You said you hate sleeping alone, so what did you try and do? She go ahead and nerd tell niggas she celibate. But she pretty as shit, and I like a challenge, so I said, the hell with it. Baby girl, my respect on the bean. If you come over to cuddle, you can lay in your jeans. And I hate clothes under my covers, but she a pretty motherfucker. I'm taking any opportunity to touch her. It must have worked because she came over. I closed my eyes and said goodnight, and she tapped me on my shoulder. Asked me because she lay on my chest, started moving closer. Now my dick like Buzz Lightyear chin. I really want to poke her. I put the TV on sleep setting. Where's the remote controller? Can you help me find it? But she accidentally found something else. Okay. I said my bad. I stared at the ceiling asking the Lord to give me strength because I'm going to need help. But then I felt her hand on my leg. And all I could think is, damn, I hate girls that play. So I gave her a kiss on the cheek, said goodnight again. She said, why are you so quick? Can we talk for a minute? Talking led to kissing. Kissing led to touching. Then I had to pause, like, hold up. Why is we doing all this if we not even fucking? She said, damn boy, why you trying to ruin shit? I said, hold up, damn, you say you was celibate? She said, I believe in love at first sight. Inside of you, I fell in love with. Get the fuck out of here. She said, no. She said, no, we fucking in here. Niggas stop bitching. Matter of fact, the big cliche, so let's take it to the kitchen. And when he said it, that's some shit that never gets mentioned. Word? I went straight for the neck, made my way down to the nipple, did a swirl with my tongue, excited about this pussy that I'm about to get into. And I don't know what to expect. She grabbed my dick, she can tell I'm here, so don't need to come. Not yet. Turned around, started playing with her belt. She crushed the back of my neck, I'm sucking on until she fucking melt. Her pants off, I'm rubbing on outside of her drawers. She took my hand, stuck the index in her mouth, and sucked the fingerprints off. Now I'm out my clothes. I dive in the pussy, gave my mouth and my nose. It smelled like nothing. Pussy dripping like water. I swear I bust her ass. A couple months later, she hit me up when she was pregnant with my daughter. Damn.
Damn, let me
run that back.
I could suck the shit out your dick. And you could give me some crazy head. You could slap my ass, pull my hair, talk dirty. All that shit is cool. But you better fucking love me. This right here is my temple. I am capable of being bringing life into this world. What? You better fucking love me. Now look, I tried the whole let's fucking be friends thing. I tried the whole no strings attached thing. And you know where that left me? Hurt, alone, confused, and in tears. I do not have time for that shit. Get fucking tested and show me the fucking papers.
Yes!
And if we make it that far, I need you to give me more than this 30-minute sex and this 5-second orgasm. I can do that shit by myself in 10 minutes. So what now? I need to understand the person that I'm letting penetrate me. I need to know your pain, your hurt, your story, your struggle, and after I see you break down, I need to be able to say, baby, you are still a king. Yeah, I could suck the shit out your dick. And you could give me some crazy head. You could slap my ass, pull my hair, talk dirty, all that shit is cool. But you better fucking love me. Daddy wasn't around so much. I ended up messing with the wrong guys. I trust no fucking men.
Hey.
Are you willing to stick around and gain my trust? Are you willing to hold me when I push you away? Are you willing to understand the method to my madness? And after you see me break down, will you still be willing to look at me and call me your queen? Yeah, I want to make love. Yeah, I want to fuck. I could suck the shit out your dick and you could give me some crazy head. You could slap my ass, pull my hair, we could talk dirty. All that shit is cool, but you better fucking love me.
So, I'ma be real personal with y'all. Anything said in this motherfucking sub stays in the motherfucking sub. Roses are red. My pussy walls are blue because I cannot find a nigga of my own to screw. For the past 4 years, I've been on team single. Woohoo. With one queen size bed. Nobody to cuddle but two body pillows. This single life is making me sick. It's like ever since the living dick quit, I've been bagging nothing but lanes and shit. For instance, this nigga named Twine, right? This nigga named Twine. He had all the right body in all the right places. I even liked it the way he used his mouth to taste it. Disregarded his slightly criminal reputation and salvated because of his fair complected skin. Giving extra notice to the dimple in his chin. But I fucked this creep, and then the next week his other bitch was calling me. See, I promise you, it was every morning, 3 o'clock, Monday, phone calls, voicemail. Bitch, I know it's you. I know he over there. Tell Twan I said, wake up. Tell Twan I said, come home. I'm tired of that nigga, stupid bitch. And sometimes I would answer just to fuck with her, like, excuse me, miss. I know you got some bills to pay, right? You know it's a work day. It's Monday, 3 in the morning. Okay, whatever. So finally I was like, you know, miss, you need some therapy. She was like, stop fucking him, just stop fucking him. He gonna leave you fat and depressed just like me. Nah, I got it, nah. First of all, I'm fat because I like to eat. Second, the only way to really get me depressed is to fuck with my money. And as you see, this nigga's phone bill ain't on again this week, so you know he ain't really getting no bread from me. The nigga really didn't get no head from me. I just liked it the way he bust open these cheeks. Oh. And we both knew he wasn't the one for me. That nigga couldn't even buy me 2-for-1 Remy. That was back in my hood rat days, you know. I had real hood ways, like drinking Mad Dog 2020 every day and shit. Hey. And shots of gin just straight up at the bar and shit. Hey. But these days, I'm on a bigger and better things, you know. I got me this extra long twin size bed in solitary confinement. I mean, Lincoln University. And I'm so appreciative of these 4 years set aside with me, myself, and I. But sometimes I really just want my own dick and my own face to ride. Especially on the thirsty nights. Especially on the thirsty nights when the tap is sapped out and I'm the only bitch walking around because I ain't got no fucking numbers to dial. I'll be like, damn, I'm the only chick in LLC not giving up the cheeks, but it's cool. It's cool. I imagine this nigga's piece. I call it hammerhead. Cause no matter his stroking technique, his meat and my G-spot would have no need, no reason but to greet repeatedly, climaxing, fucking up box springs. Yeah, I'm known to wet shit up past the sheets. Yeah, and this nigga hammerhead would look so pretty covered in me, I would have no choice but to coin my hashtag, put it down my throat, fervently. And there would be conversations held in native tongues, while I wail songs I've never sung, hammerhead and the piranha, yes, the piranha, would have no choice but to communicate. Why it took so long for us to legislate being perpendicular anytime, any place, anywhere? Just as long as he pulled my hair, arch my back and go so deep I feel his ball sack. He leaned down, grabbed my neck and whispered, take that, take that. We participate in hours of acts of forbidden pleasures. Lean back, gang bang a wood tip wine black. Take a shower and get right back to straight fucking, sucking, and ducking the cuddling. Well, maybe if his head game is the absolute best. And I'm not talking about just the sex. I'm saying our conversations would have to be endless. If it's mind-blowing sex, I'm willing to invest this dawn and make it a prominent investment. See, cause Duracell and I ain't gonna last much longer. So we're, point me in the direction of the best ass eater. Ha. And that work, like the motherfucking Energizer. No rabbit.
Just between you and I, happy as they visit.